six-time Paralympian and medalist for ice sled hockey.
Wow, Cody, learning more about this incredible Rico Roman.
Hey, if you name your kid Rico Roman, you know he's going to be cool.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah,
it's just out of the gate right there. Rico, thanks for coming on the show today. I've been so excited to meet you. I heard you were coming to town and everything, and I was like, we've got to have him on the show. Okay, let's talk a little bit about you were in the Army.
Yes.
IUD. What happened?
Yes. Sustained injuries to both my left and right leg, ultimately becoming an above-knee amputee. Mm. But I didn't let that hold me back. I got involved with adaptive sports, sled hockey being one of them, and I actually said no a bunch of times.
Did you really?
I didn't want to play or even participate, but my guys got me out there, and I was instantly hooked. That camaraderie, that brotherhood, I got that back in that locker room.
So you said no because, like, growing up, you grew up in Oregon.
Yeah,
never watched hockey,
didn't play hockey. Not a fan of it at that particular time. Huge fan now. I love being on the ice with my teammates. Nothing but fun.
Yeah, it is, like, we were talking, like, Comcast, y'all need to, like, show that all the time. Like,
somebody
needs to put this on television because sled hockey is fun to watch and brutal. You guys do not take it easy on anybody.
No, not at all. Those pads we wear for a reason, and we wear a full cage. That's how I got my teeth still, but so much fun out there.
Okay, so let's talk about winning gold medals for the USA.
Yes.
You know, you being a veteran, you being a hero and everything, and now you're getting to represent the United States again. What was that whole experience like?
Just unreal. You know, seeing our flag raised above the other flags and singing our national anthem and being alongside my teammates and being able to do that in front of my family and all the friends back home is just an honor, you know, to be able to be a part of that.
It's pretty cool. You also did something else that I thought was really cool is when you lit the cauldron at the Warrior Games.
Yes,
had to be unbelievably cool.
It was, and really touching. I mean, seeing all the guys that I had done rehab with, you know, we all, different branches of service, but, you know, kind of, met up in different places through rehab and, you know, seeing their faces. I was trying to hold it together, not to tear up in front of them. And it was an honor to be able to do that and be able to light the cauldron for the games.
That is such a cool moment,
yes,
man. The video of that is spectacular. Okay, so you've hooked up on Comcast.
Yes.
You're doing this thing. Explain a little bit to the folks at home, this essential
Internet Essentials. Yes. We've been helping low-income families as well as low-income veterans get access to internet. There's such a, you know, big gap with people that are, you know, we take for granted being able to get on the internet. Whether it's your children being able to do their homework, veterans seeking benefits, or even putting in a job application nowadays has to be done through the internet. So being able to help them with that and subsidize low-income families with internet is just awesome. And to be an ambassador and be able to help people out and to see the smiles on the kids' faces when we go to these schools and hand out computers, it's just an honor to be a part of that.
Really cool. Hey, brother, it's very nice to meet you.
Thanks so much.
Seriously,
for having me.
I'm a big fan. And next Olympics? Are you going to be there,
Fingers crossed. 2022.
Fingers crossed.
I want to be there with my teammates for sure.
I bet you'll be there, man.
Thank you so much.
Seriously, it's an honor to meet
you. Thank you, guys.
And I'm telling you, like, that sled hockey, that is fun.
Heck yeah.
I love it.